सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ब्रह्माणुजाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रणोत् तस्मै तगुम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः आम्ना यान्तिको संसिद्धम् आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनम् आपूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे The Sutra 2.2.41 is introduced by saying Kincha, meaning in continuation, moreover in continuation with what was said earlier. What was said earlier? Karanavachena Bhogadibhyaha. If you consider that the Prerana of the Ishvara to Pradhanadi as Upadana Karana is like Jivatma, Jiva giving Prerana to all the Indriyas to work, Karanas to work similarly, then it won't be so, because Jiva influences the Karanas and makes them act out for Bhoga. So such kind of dosha will accrue to Ishvara also in the exemplified. If you use that example, says the Siddhanti. Now, kincha, moreover, what? Antavattvam asarvajnyatava. Antavattvam asarvajnyatava. Now, there are two other possibilities as to antavattvam, meaning the jiva and pradhana, jiva pradhana on one side, jiva pradhana ityadi, and Ishvara. So if you start looking at these as separate entities, because Upadana Karana is separate from the Nimitta Karana, who is Ishvara. So Upadana Karana, Pradhanadi are Karanas, as you said, which they cannot be, but they are still separate. We are yet to decide what they are. And Ishvara, Maheshwara is separate. So at least two numbers are available right now in Dvaita. Now the karya which will come up with Ishvara giving prerana to Pradhanadi, the karya prapancha which comes about will be the third entity. And in this karya there will be jivas. So that itself is the third entity. Prapancha is another. So all these, meaning plurality, all this multiplicity, plurality that comes out of Dvaita. Bheda, initial Dvaita Bheda between Pradhana and Ishvara, Pradhanadi and Ishvara. That should be looked into now as to what is the resultant of that. If at all the Pradhanadi Upadana Karana is separate from Nimitta Karana, then what other doshas are possible? That should be inquired into, says the Siddhanti. And then he says Antavattvam. The resultant will be antavattvam, meaning whatever is separate from the other is limited by that. There are multiple three types of parichinnattvams, limitedness. So something is limited in time, something is limited in space, something is limited as a vastu, as a thing. So these are the three parichinnattvams that will accrue. Any limitedness will mean an end to that. Whatever is limited will come to an end. Therefore, it is that which will be antavat or antavan or antavati based on the gender. So, antavattvam to Ishvara is not desirable, it's anishta to anyone. Ishvara, who is limited by the other, will have an end. That is the meaning there. So, antavatvam and asarvajnyata, otherwise asarvajnyata. It will be clear in the vritti as to why there will be antavatvam and asarvajnyata. Pradhana jiveshwaranam या संख्या यच्च परिमाणम तद उभयम अपि ईश्वरेण परिच्छिद्यते नवा इति संदेहे. वेदर प्रधान जीव एंड ईश्वर दे आर थ्री डिफरेंट एंटिटीज एज उपादान कारण एज अ संसारी जीव एंड एज अ रूलर ईश्वर हु इज ऑल्सो निमित्त कारण. सो दीस थ्री नंबर्स यू हैव काउंटेड नाउ प्रधान जीव ईश्वर देन प्रपंच विल ऑल्सो कम अप. सो या संख्या यच्च परिमाण एंड देन दी बीइंग लिमिटेड मीनिंग बीइंग थ्री दैट इटसेल्फ इज अ लिमिटेशन इन नंबर. वन इज नॉट टू, टू इज नॉट थ्री, थ्री इज नॉट टू, थ्री इज नॉट वन, टू इज नॉट वन नॉर इज इट थ्री. सो इफ यू टेक दीज संख्यास that they are separate from each other, the numbers are different, there is a the first is not the second and so on, there is bheda. So parichinnatvam is the resultant, yachya parimanam, and if they are separate then they'll have particular size. Pradhana will have particular size, jiva will have particular size, ishvara will have particular size. So the parimana and sankhya both lead to limitedness, and they themselves have popped up due to this dvaita in the beginning. So tad ubhayam api ishvarena parichchidyatena va, sankhya and parimana. This sankhya and parimana, how many pradhanas are there? One pradhana. How many jivas are there? That has to be answered by the Maheshwara Darshanika. They say there are as many jivas as you know, as there are species, as there are individuals. So whatever if you see in an individual, it's a jiva. So there are as many jivas who are bhinna. Ishvara is one. So pradhana is one, Ishvara is one. Jivas are many. Can't give a number per se. So these sankhyas which are there, leading to pradhana, jiva and Ishvara, bheda mutually among each other, and the parimana, the size that will come along with pradhana, jiva and ishvara tag itself, tad ubhayam api ishvarena parichchidyatene va iti sandehe. Whether or not it is limited by ishvara, sankhya and parimana, meaning the number is limited by Ishvara, or other way around also, and parimana, the size also, is limiting Ishvara, and other way around, Ishvara limits the size, because being separate you cannot say that. See, separation cannot be with overlap, separation has to be with space in between, with kala in between, with vastu in between, something should be different. Whether something is there in between or not, if space is there in between, then there are two different vastus. So divided in space, divided in time, divided as vastus. Thereby parichchidyate nava iti sandehe. Sandehe sati what? Adye. Parichchinna sankhya parimanavatvat trayanam ghatavad antavatvam vinashitvam syat. Antavatvam is, I forgot to update the document. So I marked these, I forgot to update the document in PDF. So the Mula. So Antavattvam, meaning for Antavattvam, Vinashitvam. Ishvara will be Vinashi if Adhya meaning Sankhya and Parimana tad ubhayapi Ishvarana parichchidyate na vaiti sandhi. So Adhya means parichchidyate iti paksha. So in that paksha, आद्ये परिच्छिन्न संख्या परिमाणवत्वात् देन Ishvara will have limited Sankhya and Parimana. Ishvara is one, but not one without a second. He is one. Then Pradhana is second, Jiva is third. Third or many Jivas, 3, 4, 5, whatever number is there. So thereby Sankhya and size also. Ishvara will also be limited in size, because if you say there is one Pradhana outside, at least the whatever is the size of the Pradhana, that much Ishvara has reduced in size. Because whatever is the size of Ishvara, Pradhana will still be outside, Jiva will still be outside. So by Sankhya and Parimana both there will be limitation. So Parichinna Sankhya Parimana Vattvat. Since Ishvara will have Parichinna Sankhya Parimana, Parimanatva. This will be the dharma in Ishvara. Meaning Ishvara will be limited in number and size. And thereby Trayanam Pradhana Jiva Ishvaranam Ghatavat Antavattvam Vinashitvam Syat. Because all are limited by the other in Sankhya and Parimana. In size and in number, they are limited by the other. Thereby all of these three will be like Ghata. Ghata is also limited in number and size. And what do we see? Ghata is Vinashi, has Nasha. Similarly, Pradhana, Jiva and Ishvara, all of them will have Nasha. Any of them having Nasha is Anishta. Jiva having Nasha, then who will get Moksha? Pradhana having Nasha, then how there will be another Kalpa? Ishvara having Nasha anyway need not be discussed at all. Then you say, okay, there is no Parikshinnatvam, meaning Ishvarena na Parikshidyate. Iti Pakshe, Dvitiye Pakshe. If you say, if the Darshanika says no, there is no limitation in size, then what? Size and Sankhya. Then Dvitiye Ishvarasya Asarvajnyatvam Syat. There will be Asarvajnyatvam. Because there is an overlap. Who is going to control the other? How will Ishvara control someone who is not different at all, meaning not separated in any which way? In Sankhya is not different, in size also not different, then how can there be Sarvajnyatva? Asarvajnyatva. Thereby Asarvajnyatva is a dosha. Ataha Maheshwara Radhantaha Bhranti Mulaya Viti Siddham. So now there can be a question there. In your case also you talk about Vyapaka, Atma being Vyapaka and Ishvara being Vyapaka. So there in Siddhanta also there can be such dosha. So there we say this dosha, question of dosha does not arise. Why? Because in Siddhanta, in Vedanta Siddhanta, vastus are not bhinna. In your case, the Parichinna Sankhya Parimana is a dosha. In our case it is not. Why? Because if we take that Adya Paksha, if you take the Adya Paksha, there is a dosha. We don't have this Adya Paksha at all, because there is no Parichinnatvam at all. Ishvarena na Parichidyate. Ishvara is non-different from anything and everything. Ishvara appears as everything as per the Shruti. Ishavasyam idam sarvam yat kinchad agatyam jagat. So the Upanishad says that we follow that Ishvara is not separate from anything in the Prapancha, meaning everything in the Prapancha is an appearance of Ishvara. So there is no Adya Paksha. What about the Dvitiya Paksha? Na Parichidyate. There we don't have Pradhana, Jiva and Ishvara as Bhinna from each other. Only when Vastus are Bhinna. Vastu means again Vasatiti Vastu. So Vasatiti Vastu Pradhanam, Vasatiti Vastu Jivaha, Vasatiti Vastu Ishvaraha. These are the explanations that you, other Darshanikas, have given in your own Granthas. So you have to further explain and defend the doshas that we point out, we are pointing out, we show. But in our case, na parichidyate, in that paksha also, when Ishvara is not separate in Sankhya and Parimana, there is no overlap per se, because there is no bhinna overlapping. Vastuna bhinnatvena siddhe sati eva sankhyayaha sambhavat parimanasya cha. संख्या एंड परिमाण कैन बी शोन ओनली वेन वस्तुज आर भिन्न, दे आर नॉट भिन्न एट ऑल, दे आर ऑल कल्पित, भिन्नत्व इज ऑल्सो कल्पित, देर फोर प्रश्न से अनुपपत्ति, जस्ट मी वन मोमेंट प्लीज, सॉरी, टू मेनी वेदर चेंजेस, सो इफ टू मच ऑफ रेन देन देर इज कोल्ड एंड इफ देर इज नो रेन देन इट्स क्वाइट हॉट, सो देर फोर द वेरिएशंस हैव इन माई हेल्थ हैज टेकन लिटिल टोल ऑन ड्यू टू द वेदर चेंजेस, सॉरी अबाउट दैट. सो देर बाय वी डोंट हैव दिस अंतवत्व एंड असर्वज्ञता दोषास इन सिद्धांत, बट महेश्वर राधांत इज भ्रांति मूल, देर बाय दी महेश्वर सिद्धांत इज ऑल्सो शैव सिद्धांत इज ऑल्सो रिफ्यूटेड. नाउ वॉट रिमेन्स इज दी भागवत सिद्धांत और दी वॉट इज वैष्णव पक्ष, वैष्णव दर्शन, दैट हैज ऑल्सो बीन रिफ्यूटेड. सो द नेक्स्ट सेक्शन अधिकरण इज उत्पत्ति अधिकरण. So there is a Bhagavata Mata where in fact Madhvas and Vishishtadvaitins, meaning Dvaitins and Vishishtadvaitins, Madhvas and Ramanujas, they still follow this. They base their, although they call themselves as Vedantins, they follow Bhagavata and other Puranas and consider them as Pramana in such a fashion that when there is contradiction or apparent contradiction with the Shruti, they reinterpret the Shruti. They add words, etc. to the Shruti, or where Vyakarana is very clear, they use the Chandasa Prayoga in such a manner that they do the Akshara Veda. So they, what Yaskacharya has said not to be used, when Vyakrana is very clear, as per Vyakrana Sutras you can see a clear meaning and it falls in place there, then you should not use the, you should not break the word, basically you should not break the word, but only when there is dosha, I mean dosha, or there is a contradiction or you are unable to get to the right meaning, it doesn't make sense at all any which way by using the Vyakrana rules, then only you should use the, you should split the meaning, not the regular Vyakrana, but you should use the Nirukta rules. So then Nirukta, so I was trying to get to Nirukta, so Nirukta should not be used, says Yaskacharya, who is the author of the Vedanga, Nirukta Vedanga. He says that when Vyakrana rules are clearly applicable and they are showing the meaning of the Vaidika mantras or Vakyas, then and the Shabdas also, then you should not break the Shabda in a non-Vyakrana way, you should not use Nirukta. For example, you know, there is a common shloka, Guru, what is the meaning of Guru? So if you don't have the Vyakrana rule applicable there, how the Vyutpatti of Guru Shabda is, then they'll say Gukaras Chandakar Uhi Rukaras Gukaras Chandakar Rukaras Teja Uchyate. So the Gukara in the Guru Shabda is made with Gukara and Rukara. Now this Gukara and Rukara is not something that you can split in Vyakrana. There is no rule to say Gukara is some particular entity or a part in formation of the Guru Shabda and Rukara is some other part. There is no, Prakriti and Pratyaya Bhava there. There is no Upasarga or Dhatu or Prakriti Bhava. There is no such Bhava there. You cannot see any Pratyaya, Agama. You cannot see any Adesha Agama taking place from the sutras. You do not see any उपसर्गा धातु प्रातिपदिका और प्रत्यय सच कैंड ऑफ भेदास. सो हाउ इज दिस फॉर्म्ड गुकारा एज एन एंटिटी. सो देर निरुक्ता दैट इज कॉल्ड एज निरुक्ता. यू एक्सप्लेन अक्षरा और यू एक्सप्लेन अ पर्टिकुलर फोनीम. सो यू से गुकारा इज अंधकारा, रुकारा इज तेजः प्रकाश, एंड बोथ पुट टुगेदर इज गुरु. सो गुरु इज, एंड देन फाइनली द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द वर्स इज उकार च अंधकार उकार तेजोच्यते अज्ञान ग्रासकम ब्रह्म गुरुरेव न संशयः. सो वन हू रिमूव्स अज्ञान, हाउ? बाय स्वॉलोइंग अज्ञान. सो इट्स अ रेटोरिक, जस्ट लाइक सूर्य स्वॉलोज द डार्कनेस. सिमिलरली दिस गुकारा इज ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ द गुरु, रुकारा इज ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ द गुरु, अंधकारा इज ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ द गुरु विच ही कैन स्वॉलो फ्रॉम द आउटसाइड वर्ल्ड, मीनिंग द अज्ञान ऑफ द शिष्य वर्ग. ही स्वॉलोज दैट, सो दैट बिकम्स पार्ट ऑफ हिज गुरु शब्द गुकारा. एंड रुकारा इज प्रकाश. बाय रुकारा प्रकाश ही टेक्स अवे द अज्ञान, स्वॉलोज द अज्ञान ऑफ द शिष्यास, जस्ट लाइक द सूर्य स्वॉलोज द तमस एज दो. सो दिस काइंड ऑफ अ निरुक्ता ऑफ स्प्लिटिंग द अक्षराज और फोनीम्स इन सच अ द यूनिट्स विच कैन बी एकाच और हाउ एवर दैट इज स्प्लिट. दीज काइंड ऑफ मेथडोलॉजी, दिस मेथडोलॉजी रादर, दिस मेथडोलॉजी शुड बी यूज ओनली वेन द रेगुलर व्याकरण रूल्स आर नॉट अप्लाइंग और डॉट नॉट लीडिंग टू अ मीनिंग. However, the others, meaning non-Advaitins, use a lot of that in their Bhashya, Tika, Ityadi, which should not be done. And thereby they end up adding letters or, you know, with Nirukta showing some meaning. Because for Nirukta, there is no guidance per se as to what will be the meaning of this Gukara, Rukara. So there are different ways you can just push some meaning which has absolutely no basis. Because Nirukta is also shown by Yaska Muni as applicable with certain words, and where you are using Nirukta where it shouldn't be used, you don't have any basis in Nirukta also. So Nirukta kind of a methodology is being used when Vyakrana is applicable, and it is Swakapola Kalpita without any basis anywhere, no Pramana is there. And to push that additional meaning, some words may be added, some samasa kind of interpretations may also be done by them, or they are done, which is actually not sadhu. Where there is a contradiction or apparent contradiction between the Shruti and the Smriti Adi Gantha, Smriti, Purana, Itihasa, then the others should be reinterpreted, not Shruti. This is a Sampradaya. So anyway, this is something related on what we are looking at as to why the other darshanikas who have come after Adi Shankaracharya, all these darshanas, they stand refuted by Bhashya itself. Because Bhagavan Bhashyakara has refuted the darshanas, the other five darshanas, and also in the he has explained how the Sutrakara has refuted the Maheshwara and the Bhagavata Mata also. Thereby, the others who have come up after Shankaracharya, after Bhagavat Padacharya, they have started putting together pieces from other darshanas and either Maheshwara Siddhanta or the Bhagavata Mata. So these matas are okay, as long as they are not contradictory in the end goal to Shruti. So as a sadhana, as bhakti ityadi, they are good enough. But then to contradict the Shruti, they are not. And the other darshanikas who have come up with New Age Vedanta, what they have done is that they have picked from here and there and they have put together a darshana, and they say, and then thereon they have tried to attack Advaita Siddhanta using mostly Tarka. Therefore, there is a यू नो वाद ग्रंथ संप्रदाय इन बृहत प्रस्थान त्रयाय एंड देर ऑन प्रकरण ग्रंथास बेस्ड ऑन दोस वेयर बाय वी आर रिफ्यूटिंग देर आरोपास एज नॉट बीइंग एप्लीकेबल दे आर बेसिकली प्राइमरली तर्क ग्रंथास बीइंग वाद ग्रंथास देयर इज लॉट ऑफ तर्क तर्कशास्त्र एंड दिस नव्य न्याय विच इज यूज देर विच इज वेरी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड इन दैट सेंस दैट हैज बीन यूज बाय दी पूर्वपक्षी दर्शनास विच हैव कम अप लेटर सो द रिफ्यूटेशन इज ऑल्सो टू बी डन इन द सेम मैनर यूजिंग नव्य न्याय सो देर आर दीज ग्रंथास विच कीप ऑन कमिंग अप और विच हैव कम अप आफ्टर द टीकाज ऑल्सो ऑन अद्वैत ग्रंथास However, they stand refuted in pieces because such pieces have been refuted in the Bhashya itself, taking Tattad Darshana into account. So, wherever the piece of the new Darshanas have come from, that piece has been refuted in that particular section in the Sutra Bhashya Ityadi, dealing with those particular Darshanas. So just repackaging it does not make it a new darshan at all. So this has to be kept into mind. So there are some who say even Bhashya study is sufficient to understand and refute the follow-on darshanas, those which have come up later. It's new age darshanas, which is true, but then since they are using tarka, it can be, and they are attacking some things where at the Tika level, so their Bhashya study is not sufficient. Either we don't need any study further or we need a lot of study. Not need, but then if there is a doubt or if there is an interest, one can study further, but that will need Tarka study as well. So this is something that we have to keep in mind as to Maheshwara Siddhanta being refuted and Bhagavata Mata also. So Shaiva as well as Vaishnava Matas, whoever is following as a new darshana also, they stand refuted in these sutras or these adhikaranas. So with that in back in the mind, let's look at the next utpatya sambhava adhikaranam. It is introduced by in the vritti as evam kevala adhishthata ishvaraha kevala adhishthata eva ishvaraha iti vedan veda asangatamate निरस्ते सती सो वॉट मत हैज बीन रिफ्यूटेड दि माहेश्वर प्राधानता और दि दर्शन विच सेज वॉट ईश्वर इज केवल अधिष्ठाता अधिष्ठाता एव नॉट मीनिंग निमित्त कारणम नॉट दि हिज ए निमित्त कारण नॉट उपादान कारण इति वेद असंगत मत इट इज नॉट एग्रीएबल टू वेदास दैट मत इज नॉट वैदिक मत इति वेद असंगत मते निरस्ते सति हैविंग रिफ्यूटेड दैट व्हाट इज बीइंग डन नाउ इज दैट निमित्तम प्रकृतिश्च ईश्वरः इति भागवत मतस्य वेद संगतत्वात् जीवोत्पत्यंशे प्रमाण मूलत्वं स्यात् इति प्रत्युदाहरण संगत्या इदमः दि भागवत मत फॉलोअर्स दि भागवत दार्शनिकास वैष्णवास दे से दैट Maheshwara Darshana can be set aside because they have Upadana Karana which is separate from Ishwara who is Kevala Nimitta Karana. But Nimitta and Prakriti, Upadana Karana, Prakriti, both are Ishwara. Ishwara is what? Both Nimitta Karana and Prakriti. Iti Bhagavata Matasya Veda Sangatattva. This is what the Bhagavata Mata shows. If you study Srimad Bhagavatam, there also you will see finally Advaita. It seems that all this Leela is being discussed, Krishna's Janma, and then all these the entire story of Bhagavan Krishna cannot be Advaita is the thinking of many. It's not true. Bhagavatamata will also take you with hand-holding into Advaita. Therefore, Veda Sangatattvat, it is not Veda Viruddha, it is approved by Vedas. then this jiva utpatti is also discussed there. How the jiva comes about, how the prapancha srishti is there, there the jiva utpatti is also talked about. So jiva utpatti amshe pramana moolattvam syat. In that particular part, because Bhagavata Mata is Veda Sangata, therefore Jivotpatti should also be agreed with. This is the counter given by the Bhagavatas as to, it is not like your earlier refutation. Bhagavata Mata is valid, therefore Jivotpatti should be agreed with. Jivotpatti amshe pramana moolattvam syat. It has pramana, Bhagavata Mata is pramana, and therefore it's a counter example to the earlier Maheshwara Radhanta refutation. So this cannot be refuted, says the Purva Pakshi. Thereby utpatti asambhavadikaranam, this utpatti of the jiva is not possible, says the Siddhanti. Utpatti asambhavat. So utpatti kasya utpatti, jivasya utpatti is claimed by the Purva Pakshi. Phalam Purovat, meaning what? The samanvaya virodha is there or it is not there as per the Siddhanti and Purva Pakshi. Vasudeva khalu paramatma jagad upadanam nimittancha. So Vasudeva khalu, indeed isn't it so that Vasudeva is paramatma? Yes, Vasudeva is paramatma. This Vasudeva is seen as Krishna or Narayana, whatever you see Paramatma as, that Vasudeva as disclosed or revealed by Bhagavatas, he is Paramatma, and what is he? He is Jagad Upadanam Nimittancha. So he is Upadana and Nimitta of the Prapancha. We say okay, we don't have any issue. Tasmat Sankarshanakhya Jiva Udeti. Now we have an issue. From that Paramatma who is Vasudeva, there is an Utpatti of Jiva who is called as Sankarshana. So they have these names, Sankarshana. From that Sankarshana Jiva, Tasmat Pradyumnakhyam Manaha Jayate. This Manas is born from Jiva. This Jiva is born from Paramatma. Who is this? What is this Manas? The Manas, the mind, is what? Called as Pradyumna. And then tasmat aniruddhakhya ahankara jayate iti bhagavata radhanta atra vishaya. So this bhagavata talks about aniruddha after talking about manas, which is getting this name tag as pradyumna. Aniruddha is born out of this manas, which is ahankara. So what is it basically? Vasudeva is paramatma who is nimitta as well as upadana karana of prapancha. And jiva is born from if you look at it, from Vasudeva, Sankarshana, from Sankarshana, Pradyumna, from Pradyumna, Aniruddha is born. And who are they respectively? Paramatma, from Paramatma, Jiva is born, from Jiva, Manas is born, and from Manas, Ahankara is born. This is what the Bhagavata Mata is. Iti Bhagavata Radhanta Siddhanta Darshana, basically, Atra Vishayaha. Sahakim Pramana Moolaha Bhranti Moolava Iti Sande, Pramana Moola Iti Pura Paksha. This is known. Nothing to repeat there. Siddhantastu. So Siddhanti says, okay, Bhagavata Mata is Veda Sangata. Broadly, we say, okay, it is. But not in all Aumshas. Broadly. So entirely Bhagavata Mata in all the details is not Veda Sangata. Wherever there is Virodha, we do not agree. Where there is Avirodha, there we say, yes, we don't disagree. So Siddhantastu Bhavatu Veda Aviruddha Aumshe Pramana Moolatto. So what is Pramana? That which is Veda Aviruddha. Shruti Avirodha Pramana. Shruti is Pramana. Shabda Pramana. Now others also, Puranas also have Shabdas. So that is also Shabda Pramana. Unless countered it, Shabda Pramana. Meaning when the Smriti, Itihasa, Purana, Ityadi, they are in line with the Shruti, then they are also having Pramanyam. When there is no opposition also, meaning Shruti is neutral to it. Shruti does not talk about it. And then in details, some things are discussed in Purana, we don't have any issue. For example, Devatas having some Sharira, particular kind of a body. For Dhyana, something has been mentioned. Some Phala is there for such kind of a Dhyana or Upasana. We do not have any issue there. They are all Pramana. As long as they are not countered by something else, which is especially having a higher ground in Pramanyam, such as Shruti. So if it is not opposed by Shruti, we don't have any issue. It can be Arthavada, it can be any of these types of Arthavadas also. Bhuta Arthavada, or it is just a glorification. It can be any of these. Nahi Ninda Nyaya, all that is agreeable to us. But when there is Virodha, Na Tat Veda Virudha Jeevotpatti Ansha. In Jeevotpatti Ansha, there is Virodha in the Shruti. Therefore, Shruti being Moola Pramana in Atindriya Vishaya, such as Jeeva, maybe it Prakriti or Upadana Karana, Nimitta Karana, Ishvara, Swarga, Ityadi, Moksha, Atma, all of these Vishayas, for the Phala also and Sadhana also, Shruti is the only source and it is a Moola Pramana. Therefore, Veda Viruddha Jeeva Utpatti, where Jeeva Utpatti is talked about, which is Veda Viruddha, in that Ausha, there is no Pramana Moolattvam. There, this Bhagavata Mata, wherever you find its source, it is not Pramana. Kutaha, why so? Vasudeva Jeevasya Utpatti Asambhavat, because there is no possibility of Jeeva Utpatti from Vasudeva. Who this Vasudeva itself is, you know, under discussion, Lakshana wise. Vasudeva, Vasudeva Putra, Vasudeva, Krishna, who is Paramatma, so far we agree, as an avatara. And since that Krishna is an avatara of Paramatma, he is not different from Paramatma. We talk about Krishna as Bhagavan, Krishna, Paramatma. Somewhere Bhagavan Bhashyakara even mentions iti Ishvara Uvacha or something like Ishvara Ah, while pointing out to a statement made by Krishna. So Bhagavan Krishna is seen as Paramatma Swayam, Ishvara Swayam. So we don't have any issue when you call him as Vasudeva, Krishna, with any name. We do not have such issues, because for us it is all Paramatma. When you say Vishnu also, we will say Vishnu as what Dvaitin see as Vishnu and what we see as Vishnu are different. We will say Vishnu is, who is Vishnu? Vyapaka Tattva. Vyapakatvat Vishnu. Who is Paramatma? Which Paramatma? That Abhinna Nimitta Upadana Karana, who appears as the Prapancha due to Maya Shakti, and he is himself not deluded, and without being deluded, as though becomes all the jivas, samsari jivas. That is this Vishnu, Ishvara. So kutaha, why is it that broadly you say that Bhagavata Mata is valid, has pramanyam, but there is no pramanatva or pramana moolatva in the case of jiva utpatti? Because it is not possible for jiva to have utpatti from Vasudeva, let alone anything else. There is no utpatti possible at all for jiva. Purvapakshi asks why. So there, yadi utpatti rangi kriyate, if at all this utpatti of jiva is accepted by any darshanika, tarhi ghatavad anityatva apatya, then there will be ghatavat anityatva apatti prasanga. Whatever has utpatti will have nasha. Whatever has utpatti has nasha. You do not have sadhi which has no nasha. To this the Purvapakshi may say that there is pradhvamsa. Pradhvamsa abhava. So pradhvamsa is after ghatanasha. So ghata is an example again. Ghatavat anityatva apatti. Like ghata, there will be anityatva prasanga if at all jiva is utpanna. So jiva will also have anityatvam. Jiva will have nasha, and therefore jiva will become anitya. Then who will have moksha? if jiva is anitya, who is the one who is seeking for moksha? If it is the same anitya jiva who is seeking moksha, then he is being anitya. Who will the moksha accrue to? Who will get this phala? The entire darshana, which talks about moksha as an end result sought after by the jiva granted by Paramatma, and an ananda avastha which is nitya, will not be given to this jiva who is a seeker. The seeker gets nothing. So the Shruti promises something, or your Bhagavata Mata promises something, and it is not delivered because there is no person to deliver to. When moksha is available, jiva is not available. So when moksha is to be given as phala, this jiva has undergone nasha. To this the Purvapakshi may ask, what about, why are you giving ghata example? I have a counter example. How about ghata pradvamsa abhavaha? That has utpatti, it is sadhi. Because pradvamsa abhava, when does it come up? Pradvamsa, when there is pradvamsa, there are four abhavas. Pragabhava, and then Pragabhava is the example here, not pradvamsa abhava. See, pradvamsa abhava is pradvamsa. When does it come about? Pradvamsa abhava. Abhava. So pradvamsa abhava is different from pragabhava, and there is anyonya abhava, and there is the abhava which is generally talked about as what? The general abhava case. So the pragabhava, when is pragabhava destroyed? Pragabhava is destroyed when the, meaning prior non-existence of ghata. Before the ghata is born, there is pragabhava of ghata. That pragabhava is destroyed when the ghata comes up. So it is what? It is anadi, but not ananta. It is with anta. It is santa. So pragabhava has an end but does not have a beginning. What about pradvamsa abhava? Pradvamsa abhava has a beginning but does not have an end. So pradvamsa is an abhava which comes up when the ghata is destroyed. So when the pot has a nasha or dvamsa, pradvamsa, that time this abhava comes up. So this abhava is born. Which abhava? The ghata's pradvamsa abhava. After the destruction of the ghata, nasha of the ghata, dhamsa, the abhava that is born is called as pradvamsa abhava. So that is sadhi, meaning it has a beginning. And what is the siddhanti saying? Siddhanti says that yadi utpatti angi kriyate jivasya tarhi ghatavid anityatva apatti syat. And then hetu apatya. But pradvamsa abhava, ghata pradvamsa abhava, or any pradvamsa abhava has an utpatti. So utpatti angi kriyate kasya pradvamsa abhavasya tarhi ghatavad anityatva apatti nasti. Anityatva, because ghata pradvamsa abhava is born. When will this pradvamsa go? It will never go. Even if another pot is created, then this pradvamsa will still be there, because this pradvamsa is Pratiyogi is the earlier ghata which has undergone nasha. So that ghata pradvamsa abhava will be nitya. So it is sadhi but ananta, it is nitya. Similarly, this jiva also can have utpatti but no nasha, says the Purvapakshi Bhagavata. So there the answer is what? No, bhava padartha. We are discussing bhava padartha, not abhava padartha. Let abhava be padartha, but bhava padarthas that have utpatti is jiva abhava padartha or bhava padartha. Jiva is bhava padartha. So bhava padartha padarthasya jivasya utpatti angi kriyate chet tarhi ghatavad anityatva apatti. The abhava padartha like pradvamsa abhava can be nitya, mean nitya in a sense it may be ananta after the utpatti. But whatever has an utpatti, in fact we will say the definition of nityatvam is kalatraya nityatvam. If we say the nityatvam should be in all three kalas, and Pradvamsa Bhava will also not fit the case because it was not existent before the Ghatanasha. So anyway, this kind of an argument should be kept into mind because Tarkikas will bring that as a meaning Abhava as a counter example, which does not hold good here. So यदि उत्पत्ति जीवस्य उत्पत्ति अंगीक्रियते तर्हि घटवद अनित्यत्व आपत्ति स्यात् तया आपत्या घटवद अनित्यत्व आपत्या भगवत प्राप्ति रूप मोक्षः तदभ्युपगतः कस्य स्यात्। पूर्वपक्षी इज आस्ट, सिद्धांति आस्ट द पूर्वपक्षी, हु इज गोइंग टू कस्य मोक्षः स्यात्, विच मोक्ष, भगवत प्राप्ति रूप मोक्ष। This, what is moksha as per your own darshana, not our darshana. In your darshana, what do you have? Bhagavatamata says that moksha is attainment of Bhagavan. In that kind of a form is moksha. You attain Bhagavan. Whether you attain as an ahamsha, whether you become one with it, whether you become part of it, whether you get rupa, whether you get loka, whatever it is that your darshana talks about, that kind of a moksha is given to a jiva, but this jiva being anitya, who will get that moksha? Kasya syat. Tadabhyupagata, accepted by you, not by us. You have to explain what you have accepted in your darshana. That moksha, that kind of a moksha, kasya syat. To whom will it be given as a result? Ataha, bhranti mula bhagavata siddhanta. So kasya is not something that can be answered, so it is a rhetoric. Kaimutika nyayina. अतः भ्रांति मूला भागवत सिद्धांत भागवत सिद्धांत इज भ्रांति मूला इट हैज नो प्रमाण एज बेसिस एस्पेशली इन जीव उत्पत्ति इत्यादि अंशास इत्थम जीव जन्म निरस्य ततः मनोजन्म निरस्यति नाउ जीव जन्म इज नॉट देयर व्हाट अबाउट मनो मनस माइंड बीइंग बोर्न आउट ऑफ जीव अहंकार बीइंग बोर्न आउट ऑफ द माइंड दैट इज स्टिल टू बी रिफ्यूटेड सो इन जीव उत्पत्ति अंश इट इज भागवत Mata is not Pramana. Then the Manojanma from Jiva. Nachak Kartuk Karanam. Nachak Kartuk Karanam. So Kartuhu. The Purvapakshi says that Manas is born from Jiva. So we take an example. Manas is what? Antakkarana. Antakkarana. Or any karana. Antakkarana is just one karana. Any karana you take as an example. Manas is a karana. Be it antakkarana, but it is a karana. Have you ever seen any karana being born from jiva? Any karana. You have to give an example in the loka. Have you seen anything like that? So, kartuhu karanam jivat na. कर्तु करणम जीवात न उत्पद्यते न च उत्पद्यते सो दैट कैन बी दी बेसिक वृत्ति देर बिकॉज देर इज नो पदच्छेद देर दैट इज द बेसिक वृत्ति मीनिंग जीवात कर्तु जीवा इज द कर्ता सो जीवात कर्तु पंचमी एक वचन करणम न च उत्पद्यते डज नॉट इज नॉट बॉर्न फ्रॉम करणा नो करणा इज बॉर्न फ्रॉम Jiva, who is a karta. So from karta, karana is not born. Karta is a karaka, kartru karaka. Karana is a karaka, karana karaka. You don't have this karaka, one karaka being born from the other. Specifically here, karana karaka being born from kartru karaka. Divritti says kartu who is that karta? Devdatta, devdatta ityadi. So from devdatta, yajniratta, whoever that is, chaitra, maitra. So kartu hu devdatta dehe sakashat from Devadattadi who are kartas, from them karanasya, karana like what? Kuthara ityadi. So karana, manas is like any other karana. It is an instrument. And we give a gross instrument which can be seen. So kuthara adi, axe etc. Or any kuthara is what do you call that? What is the word for kuthara in English? Not sure, cannot recall rather. So kuthara is it's a, let me just see, axe is okay, but a spade, I think, yeah, a spade or something like that. Yeah, spade. Spade is a. So, an axe or a spade, basically take any example. Danda chakra is also fine. So, danda chakra, kuthara, ityadi. So, danda chakra are not born from the kulala. They are all instruments. So, kuthara adi are not born from devadattadi. सो कर्तुः देवदत्तादेः सकाशात् कर्णस्य कुठारादेः उत्पत्त्यदर्शनात् लोके इन दि लोके यू डू नॉट सी उत्पत्ति ऑफ एनी इंस्ट्रूमेंट फ्रॉम द कर्ता देयर फोर जीवात् कर्तुः जीवा इज अ कर्ता एंड फ्रॉम जीवा यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट मनोत्पत्ति दि मन उत्पत्ति दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल मनोजन्म सो जीवात् कर्तुः करणम विच इज मनस जन्यते इति एतद् असंगतम इत्यर्थः This is not valid. Even if Bhagavata says this, this Bhagavata Darshana will be invalidated, although it talks about it, because it has Pratyaksha Virodha, it has Shruti Virodha also. Nanu Vasudevat na Sankarshanasya Janma, Napi Sankarshanat Pradyumnasya Ityetra Ishtapattim Ashankyaha. Now if we say, okay, there is no उत्पत्ति ऑफ संकर्षणा फ्रॉम वासुदेव मीनिंग जीवा फ्रॉम परमात्मा एंड नॉट इवन उत्पत्ति ऑफ प्रद्युम्न फ्रॉम संकर्षणा मीनिंग व्हाट मनस फ्रॉम जीवा पूर्व पक्षी भागवत से इष्टापत्ति ओ दिस इज समथिंग दैट वी ऑल्सो एग्री विथ व्हाट यू आर रिफ्यूटिंग इज नॉट अ रिफ्यूटेशन ऑल वी डोंट मेक सच क्लेम्स इफ एट ऑल दी भागवत दार्शनिका सेज सच अ थिंग देन इति आशंक्याह विज्ञानादि भावे वातर प्रतिषेधः विज्ञानादि भावे वातर प्रतिषेधः सो देर दी सिद्धांती सेज विज्ञानादि भावे वा तर प्रतिषेध हियर ऑल्सो देर इज नो पदच्छेदा टू बी डन तर प्रतिषेध इज अ समास सो दी विज्ञानादि भावे मीनिंग त्रयाणाम All these three, who are those? Sankarsana, Pradyumna, and then yeah, Vasudeva. So if you look at this, Utpatti Krama has been mentioned. So Vasudeva is Paramatma, Sankarsana is born from that, Pradyumna, and then Aniruddha. So Vasudeva is Paramatma, Sarvajna. So there is no Vijnanadi Abhava there in Paramatma. But Sankarsana, Pradyumna and Aniruddha, who are respective of Jiva, Manas and Ahankara. Now whether they have Vijnana or not, Vijnanadi, which are Paramatma Gunas basically. So there the Siddhanti asks whether they have Vijnana or not. सो दि विज्ञान ऐश्वर्य विचार दि परमात्म गुणास विल दे बी इन जीवा मनस एंड अहंकार ऑल थ्री इफ दे हैव विज्ञान आदि अभावे आर डू दे हैव और डू दे नॉट हैव सो विज्ञान आदि भावे विज्ञान आदि भावे व तद अप्रतिषेध सो विज्ञान आदि आर देर मीनिंग ऐश्वर्य इज देर सर्वज्ञत्व ऑल दीज गुणास विच आर देर इन दि परमात्मा दे आर देर इन दी संकर्षणादि त्रय इवन इफ दे हैव भावे अपि यू कैन यू नो भावे अपि और या वा वा देन व्हाट विल हैपन उत्पत्ति इज नॉट पॉसिबल तद प्रतिषेध देर इज प्रतिषेध हाउ देर इज प्रतिषेध प्रकारांतरेण सो इन अनदर वे देर बी प्रतिषेध As in, we'll see in the vritti. This is a little tricky to explain in the sutra. We'll see in the vritti. Difficult to make up because it will be a long vritti. Because tara pratishedha, simply we can say tara pratishedha jiva utpatti apratishedha. So we can say vijnanadi bhave trayanam. Trayanam sankarshanadi nam trayanam. Meaning sankarshana, pradyumna and aniruddha. All these three, if they have vijnanadi bhava, sarvajnyatvadi, whatever are the vijnana, aishwarya, All these which are discussed in the Bhagavata Darshana, if they are there, those dharmas are there in the other three who are born respectively from the. You are saying that they are not born. So, what you are saying, वासुदेवा संकर्षण से जन्म न, संकर्षणात प्रद्युम्न से जन्म न, सो वी आर नॉट क्लेमिंग दैट इष्टापत्ति, ओके देन दीज थ्री आर देयर, देर इज नो जन्म, बट डू दे हैव विज्ञान, विज्ञानादि मीनिंग ऐश्वर्य इत्यादि, ऑल दीज थ्री आर मीनिंग ऑल दे ऑल ऑफ देम आर ईश्वराज और नॉट ईश्वराज, आर दे सिमिलर टू ईश्वरा और दे आर दे ईश्वराज देमसेल्व्स, सो दैट इज दी क्वेश्चन दैट इज गोइंग टू कम अप, देयर बाय दे आर नॉट बॉर्न, सो वॉट इज बींग सी वॉट इज द डिस्कशन, उत्पत्ति उत्पत्ति असंभवाधिकरणम, सो उत्पत्ति ऑफ जीव मनस एंड अहंकार ऑल थ्री आर नॉट पॉसिबल. नाउ वॉट हैव वी रिफ्यूटेड, वी हैव रिफ्यूटेड दैट द सिक्वेंशियल उत्पत्ति ऑफ जीव मनस एंड अहंकार वी हैव नॉट डिस्कस बिकॉज द पूर्व पक्षी इज सेइंग दिस यू नो द जीव इज नॉट बॉर्न फ्रॉम परमात्मा and we are not saying that jiva is born from paramatma, so if you say that we agree with it, ishtapatti, and manas is not born from jiva, but they are not saying manas is not born, jiva is not born, they are just saying not born from ishvara, not born from jiva respectively, and ahankara need not be discussed because manas has been refuted to be born from jiva and jiva has been refuted to be born from ishvara, they say ishtapatti. So they are saying there is jiva utpatti, mana utpatti and ahankara utpatti, but it is not from ishvara, jiva and manas respectively, but utpatti is there. So what is the sutra saying? Vijnanadi bhave api or va, even if you say, so va meaning pakshe as to utpatti being there, they all these three have Ishwara Bhava or they are Tulya. So they are Ishwara or they are Tulya to Ishwara, Paramatma Vasudeva. So if you say Vijnanadi Bhave Va, you can read both Pakshas. Tara Pratisheda meaning Utpatti Pratisheda. Utpatti of Tad means Jiva Utpatti, Mana Utpatti and Ahankara Utpatti Pratisheda. There is still dosha, meaning there is opposition to that. We do not agree that there is jiva utpatti, jivadi utpatti. We will say jivadi utpatti, jiva, manas and ahankara utpatti is not possible. The way you discuss it. We also talk about utpatti of manas and buddhi ityadi ahankara, but they are discussed as being put together from the meaning re-manifest from the Mahabhutas across kalpas. So across kalpas there is continuation of the Sukshma Sharira and the components are to be shown as to what is the dharma of each particular Sukshma Sharira component, whether it is manas or indriyas ityadi. So we talk about the utpatti, but utpatti is not as being born afresh. And they are definitely not born from Jiva or Paramatma. Jiva being born from Paramatma and Antakkarana ityadi sequence, the way they have talked about in Bhagavata Darshana. So let's look at the take, it will be clear. Sankarshanadinam Trayanam Vasudevavat Vijnanadi Bhaveva Vijnanaishwarya Balavat Nirdosha Niravadya Swarupatve api. So vijnanadi bhave, so they have vijnanadi bhava, vijnanaditva or vajnanam, so bhava pratyaya has to be read there. So vijnana aishwarya, what are these adipadena? Aishwarya, balavat, nirdosha, niravadya, swarupatve api. So even if the three, starting with sankarshana, so sankarshana, pradyumna and Aniruddha, if they have meaning jiva, manas and ahankara, even if they have vijnana, aishwarya, balavat, they are nirdosha, niravadya, that kind of swarupa they have, even if they have that, tarapratisheda is tasya utpatya sambhava rupa doshasya prakarantarena apratisheda ityartha. In another manner, also if you try to establish in another manner, it can be refuted as to they having Utpa, they are having Utpatti. there being born, jiva being born. Primarily we want to talk about jiva being born. Kim vasudevadayaha chatvarah api ishvarah. So when the vijnana adi are there, meaning vijnana, aishwarya, all bala ityadi are there. If vijnana, aishwarya, bala are there, jivas can also have. A king can have aishwarya, very learned pandita can have vijnana, or let's say a king who has studied a lot of shastra can have vijnana also, aishwarya also, and have bala also, being kshatriya king. So kim vasudevadayaha chatvarah api ishvara. So vasudeva, sankarsana, pradyumna and aniruddha, all those four are ishvaras, or uta sankarsana adaya trayaha vasudeva tulyaha. Meaning Vasudeva alone is Ishvara and other three are Tulya, comparable to Ishvara, but they are not Ishvara themselves. So either all four are Ishvaras or one is Ishvara Vasudeva and other three are similar to this Vasudeva who is Ishvara. If you say all four are Ishvara, Adye Bhagavan Ekaha Eva Vasudeva Iti Swasiddhanta Hanihi. Then Bhagavata Mata, which says that Bhagavan is only one Vasudeva, nobody else is Vasudeva, nobody is Bhagavan, nobody is Ishvara, only one Bhagavan, one Ishvara, who is Vasudeva. Nobody else, no other name is also acceptable to you, then that Swasiddhanta Hani will take place. Dvitiya meaning, Vasudeva is Ishvara, but the other three are Ishvara Tulya, they are not Ishvaras. Dvitiya Utpatya Sambhava Doshaha Taravastava Evaiti Bhavaha. But the Utpatti is not established. How is Utpatti established? They are similar to Ishvara, but they are not born from Ishvara. Ishvara is Sarvajna Sarvavitityadi. Now, where is the connection between these three and the others? So, they are Ishvara Tulya, but they are not Ishvara. But what are they then? How do you make a connection at all? What is the Sambandha there? So, all those doshas will still accrue and Utpatti is not established. Utpatti Asambhava Dosha Taravastayava. Why? Because earlier tadavastha means whatever has been argued. Ghatavad anityatva apatya bhagavat prapti rupa moksha tad tvad abhyupakataha kasya syat. Who will get this moksha? Utpatti is still not possible, because if you claim utpatti without being Ishvara, they still have utpatti, then who will get the moksha? And karna cannot be born again. Karna we are not discussing anymore. We have already refuted that it is not born from jiva. Then let it be there. Let's say karna is there and both karnas are there. Mana also, ahankara also. Ahankara is not really a karna, but let it be a role of that particular karna, whichever karna it is. But ahankara also cannot be born in that manner, the way you are talking about. Manas cannot be born the way you are talking about. Jiva cannot be born in any which way. Why? Because jiva, if jiva is agreed to be born, then earlier dosha is taravastha. It is not refused, meaning it is not taken away. Just by saying that they are having vijnanadi, still the dosha does not go away. They can have vijnana, they can have bala, they can have aishwarya, but how will that take away the anityatva dosha? Being born, they will not be nitya. Then moksha, who will get moksha? That argument that we have made still cannot be countered. That dosha we have pointed out cannot be countered. The last shloka, last sutra there, apicha. Further what? Vipratishedacha. Vipratishedacha. So there is vipratisheda also. Meaning there is contradiction in your own darshana. What is the contradiction? Kvachit jnanaishwarya shakti bala virya tejamsi vasudevasya guna iti. Kvachit cha ukta guna eva vasudeva iti guna guninoho bhedam abhedancha varnayanti. So your Bhagavata Mata has a contradiction within. Some places you talk about jnana, aishwarya, shakti, bala, virya, teja, all these are vasudeva gunas. So there are a lot of gunas discussed. You say, or some places later darshanas who follow this, they say there is the ananta guna. They talk about ananta guna narayana. So this Vasudeva, who has these listed gunas or many other gunas also unlisted, Whereas kvachitcha ukta guna eva vasudeva iti. So these gunas themselves are vasudeva. So sometimes you say gunas are there and vasudeva is a guni, whichever be these gunas. Elsewhere you say guna and guni have abheda. So ukta guna eva vasudeva. These gunas meaning jnana is vasudeva, aishwarya is vasudeva, shakti is vasudeva, bala is vasudeva, virya, teja, all these are vasudevas. So vasudeva himself is all of these. Some other place he has these gunas. So guna guninoho bheda abheda, bhedam abhedancha varnayanti. So they talk about bheda also, they talk about abheda also. Sometimes they may talk about bheda and abheda together also. There are other darshanas which have come up. They call themselves as what they say, they are shuddha dvaita. So shuddha dvaita is actually shuddha dvaita if you look at it, because they accept dvaita in baddhavastha, real dvaita. Real dvaita in bhedavastha, in baddhavastha, and real advaita in mokshavastha. So how will real bheda become real advaita, abheda? It's not possible. If something is really different, like ghata and pata, different from each other, then ghata can never become pata. Pata can never become ghata. So ghata pata, which are having real bheda, can never have real abheda. Similarly, if in mokshavastha there is real abheda, after is to have in moksha, there has to be real abheda, then in the baddhavastha also there cannot be real bheda. Real bheda cannot get converted into real abheda at all. Kalpita bheda is possible. That's why shuddha advaita, shuddha advaita is not advaita at all. It's a misnomer. It is shuddha advaita. Kevala, so therefore advaita, to differentiate from these dvaita advaita, shuddha advaita, all these, advaita has to differentiate. So advaita can be seen as kevala advaita. There is nothing else. There is no shuddha, shuddha. All these terms are, visheshanas are not needed. It is kevala advaita. So anyway, let's I'll just finish this. Therefore tathacha parasparam vipratishedat. Vipratishedat is from the sutra cha. And therefore tathacha cha from the, and therefore also, due to having mutual contradiction in your own darshanas, it is not a something which can be interpreted, reinterpreted. There is dosha in your own virodha in your own darshanas. Apramanikam idam bhagavatamatam ityartha. This bhagavatamata is apramanika. Tasmad evam sankhya vaisheshika saugatarhata maheshwara bhagavatamatanam bhranti mulatvena taihi mataihi niravadyad advaitad brahmanah jagat sargam bruvan. There is a typo here. Jagat sargam bruvan samanvayah na virudhyate iti siddham. So this avirodha in the second pada is concluded by showing that Bhagavata Mata is also apramanika, and what other matas have been refuted here. Tasmat evam, in this manner, Sankhya Mata, Vaisheshika Mata, Saugata is Bauddha Mata, Arhata is Jaina Mata, Maheshwara Shaiva, and Bhagavata, which is Vaishnava Mata. Broadly, there can be various flavors also. All these matas are having no basis in pramana, so bhranti mula, they are bhranti mula, and therefore through bhranti mula tvena hetoho taihi mataihi niravadya. This advaita mata is niravadya. There is, you cannot show any dosha in advaita mata. So taihi mataihi niravadyat advaitat brahmanaha, from this Brahma, which is not having any dosha, from that Advaita Brahma, from that Brahma who cannot be shown as any other Paramatma of the Darshanikas, meaning whether it is Purusha of the Sankhyas or who is completely neutral, Udasina, or who is basically bhogi, who is not a karta but bhogi, or of the Maheshwaras who is a Nimitta Karana but not Upadana Karana, or of the Bhagavatas who is Nimitta Karana, Upadana Karana but also Upadana for Jivas. Thereby, such kind of claims are refuted. Or what? There is no Paramatma at all of the Sankhyas. Or Maheshwara Siddhanta also was refuted by saying that if it is just a Nimitta Karana, if this Ishwara is a Nimitta Karana, then there will be Ragadi Doshas. So that will also be making this Ishwara as not Niravadya. Will be having Doshas. Therefore, this Brahma who is free from Doshas, Niravadya, this Brahma that we talk about, Advaita Brahma, is Niravadya Brahma. Does not have these ragadi doshas, being only Nimitta Karana, does not have a, become a bhogi, just like Sankhya's Purusha, who is Udasina but a bhogi. In Srishti is Udasina but bhogi. Others, and there are others who do not have Ishwara at all, like Bodha and Jaina. So this Brahma is free from faults. Taihi mataihi niravadyad Advaitad Brahmanaha Jagat Sargam Bruvan Samanvaya. The Samanvaya which talks about Utpatti of the Prapancha from that kind of Brahma who is free from any defects such as Bhogi or any of the other doshas which have been pointed out so far. Na Virudhyate. Samanvaya Na Virudhyate Iti Siddham. Taihi Na Virudhyate. Taihi Mataihi. So Taihi Mataihi Na Virudhyate. Kutaha. So Anvaya is Taihi Mataihi Bhranti Mulatvena Na Virudhyate, Samanvaya Na Virudhyate, and Niravadyat Advaitat Brahmana Sargam Bruvan Samanvaya. What Samanvaya? That Samanvaya which is this Niravadyat Advaitat is not a Hetav Panchami, it is Upadane Panchami. Apadane Panchami. So Apadana is Brahma, which Brahma? Niravadya Advaita Brahma. From that there is Jagadutpatti. Says this Samanvaya, so that Samanvaya of the Shruti na viridyate, kuta na viridyate taihi bhranti mulatvena, tesham matanam bhranti mulatvena. All those matas are established or shown, proven as having bhranti mula, not pramana mula. Thereby there is an end of this dvitiya pada in the dvitiya adhyaya. There is a mangalacharana by the vrittikara who says yat sakshat kritaye sarva vedantanam samanvaye Parastav para radhanta virodastadham param. Iti Shri Brahma Tattva Prakashikayam Dvitiya Adhyasya Dvitiya Padaha. So the Brahma Tattva Prakashika ends here with the Mangalacharana, which says what? Yat Sakshat Kritaye. Sakshat Kriti is the Pratipadika. Tassi Sakshat Kritaye. Sarva Vedantanam Samanvaye. Sarva Vedantanam Samanvaye Parastaha Para Radhanta Virodaha Parastaha. So what is Parastaha? What has been refuted? Para Radhanta, Para Darshana Siddhanta Darshana. So Virodha by the other Radhantas, meaning Para Radhanta, Paraihi Radhantaihi Yah Virodaha Sah Virodaha Parastaha. Kasmin Vishay Virodaha Samanvaye. Samanvaye Vishay Saptami. Sarva Vedantaram Samanvaye Vishaye Yah Paraihi Radhantaihi Virodaha Pradarshitaha. Sah Virodaha Parastaha. For what reason has it been done? Tadarte Chaturthi. Yat Sakshat Kritaye. Yasya Brahmana Sakshat Kritaye. For Sakshatkara. Sakshat Kriti Sakshatkara. So for Sakshatkara of Brahma, Brahmatma, the Samanvaya was established for that purpose. Sarva Vedantaram Samanvaya. And that Samanvaya, unto that Samanvaya, there was Virodha by all these Darshanas, shown by all these Darshanas, claimed to have Virodha. That Virodha has been, Parastha has been won over, has been shown to be flawed. And that yat, so yasya sakshat, yasya brahmana sakshat kuru, yes, that yat and tat should be seen as a complement. They are in samanadhikaranyam. So yat brahma, yasya brahmana sakshat krutaye sarva vedantanam samanvayah, tasmin samanvaye पराधान्तैहि यः विरोधः परास्तः तद् ब्रह्म तत् परम ब्रह्म अहम् अस्मि. दैट इज अन्वय. सो अहम् परब्रह्म अस्मि. कीदृश परब्रह्म अस्मि अहम्? यस्य साक्षात्कार अपेक्षितः. दैट साक्षात्कार साक्षात्कृति इज आई एम वांटिंग दैट साक्षात्कार. सो Tadarthi, for that purpose, the Samanvaya was presented, and unto that Samanvaya there was a lot of Virodha shown by many Darshanikas. All those Virodhas have been shown to be Bhranti Mula, because their Darshanas are Bhranti Mula. Virodha is definitely Bhranti Mula. Therefore, Parasa, they have been destroyed actually. All their claims have been shattered, and thereby that samanvaya established into that very brahma revealed by the all the Vedanta Vakyas, that parabrahma I am, says the Mangalacharana Shloka. So we'll stop here. Sorry for taking a little longer. I went a little slow earlier. Anyway, so I'll see you in the next part. Amnayante samsiddham adi madhyanta varjitam ananda ghanam apurnam atma jyotir upasmahe. Namaste, dhanyavada.
Namaste.